Wait, listen. All right, Vignesh starts. Yeah.
So, as a group are going to present to you on a topic called Thinking Six, Thinking Fast. The idea behind this is basically was a book written by a guy called Edward E. Bono. In this, he presented his own ideas of having a more cohesive thought process. What he did was, he divided the thought processes into six distinct areas. And the concept behind the hats is each hat is of a different color, and metaphorically each of those represents a direction in which you're supposed to think. So this is how it goes. The blue hat is for the thinking process. So basically the person with the blue hat is like your mediator, he controls the discussion. The white hat is the one with all the information and facts. He presents all the facts to you. And the red hat is a part of emotions, and it's all the spontaneous feelings and emotions which you're supposed to have. So generally, you wear the red hat for a very less amount of time as compared to the other ones. The green hat is the hat of creativity, in which you have all your ideas and all that stuff. The yellow hat is the hat of optimism and benefits related to it. And lastly, the black hat is the critical hat. It's all the negative parts of it and the cautionary aspects of it. So this is how the hat is divided. And it's like a detailed description of the hats. Okay, fine. So these are all the hats. So basically, we have a skit for you people to demonstrate how each direction of the hat works. So this will be presented to you by this people. And Niveda will be the mediator. So that's all.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. We have a skit for you. In case you guys don't hear anything, please let us know. We will repeat it for you. I hope you all can enjoy this. So basically, like, we are an ad agency, okay? This is a meeting. Basically, what I did, we decided on ad type. So we have a customer among us who wants an ad to be decided. So basically, the story was how our meeting goes on, how we discuss, how we come up with ideas. Okay, everything clear? Any questions? So, okay, we are going to start right now. Good morning, everyone. We have Mrs. Chipkure among us. She has come to us so that we can get an awesome ad for a delicious chips, apparently. So I guess everybody is ready to brainstorm. Let's come up with ideas. Okay. So anyone with some idea that we can start discussing on?
I have an idea. I mean, more people. Teeth and brains, it all makes sense, but come on, let's go to the playground.
Okay.
talking about fat girl, don't even ask me, I don't know where they're going. Being critical about every single thing. Just stop, okay? We'll go one by one, largely not going to be anywhere. So, everybody drop your hats. Okay, so we'll go one by one. First of all, Mrs. Chukule, who exactly is this so-called delicious soup of yours? Okay, so guys, the target audience is youngsters, young people. So any substantial data about what exactly attracts a young crowd to buy certain products or others?
See, according to statistics, 70% of the youngsters follow that brand which has been endorsed by famous personality like an actor or a sportsman.
Yeah, movie stars, they influence people to buy, right?
Anyone else? to find solution to anything, you need to look at it from various points of view. You can't just be critical of it, you can't just be optimistic as such. You have to look at the facts, you have to look at the situation, you have to analyze it from every angle. Like when Shreya started off, she was like, let's make it all musty and all that stuff, but just that won't work. So then Krash had to come in and give some caution and stuff, and then the facts had to be repeated. So overall, basically, to find any solution to any problem, a good solution that is, you have to look at it from all possible angles, you have to use all of the hacks. But in order, you can't just let it all mix together.
Yeah, so the thing was, the why Edward brought up what this thing was, see, when you have a group discussion or anything, everybody thinks differently. Someone will tell you that gut instinct, which will up there and come, which will pata. And then someone will give you only facts and figures. Then they won't give you opinion. They tell you, hey, by these stats, this is the probability of this working out. So usually companies do this, this is gonna work. And then someone else will be very critical. They tell you, this is not feasible, this won't work, and someone else will always see the positive side. Now the thing is, this cross-thinking. Everything gets cut off. So, Edward Waller got this thing, like mentally you wear a cap. Where white hat is basically, think about a plain white paper with printed facts. So when you don white hat, you talk only about facts. No opinions, nothing. Facts, figures. What are the facts? What are the figures? Then we move on to the feeling, the red hat. Red hat like now, dangerous. You wear this only for 30 seconds or so, very short time, because it's your intuition. You think you wear a white for long and commit judgments, right? So you wear it only for a little time. You wear it and you can say, what do you feel? Your gut instincts. I feel this is gonna work, but I like this, this will make people feel good. Something like that. The black hat comes during the end. Like, see, once you have explored the agenda and developed your possible solutions, the sets of solutions are then criticized when you all don the black hats and you criticize it. Is this feasible? Are there any other problems regarding this? Can you shoot that at this particular time? Is the location feasible? Anything like that. And then finally, the blue hat is the moderator. He moderates everyone, he or she, and then make sure that the people don't go out of topic. Okay? This is your life example. I don't know if you guys know this or not, Speedo. It's a company which makes swimsuits. And they are very well known for their swimsuits. I think it's 2008 Olympics, they had this awesome swimsuit. Michael Phelps wore that suit for like all the, and he won like eight times, he wore it seven, and he won all the seven medals in 2010. And then the people, they kind of banned that suit. Now, by the next Olympic, 2012, under 4 years, they have to come up with an awesome suit that should not get banned, but they should still maintain their priority. They are that they are the best. Okay? So what these people do is they use the six thinking hats method. Among other things. What they did was they didn't have a meeting in the normal meeting room. They went out. They went to some hotels. They had it in unusual places. And what they did was they had different hats. The green one was supposed to come with wacky ideas, crazy ideas. Didn't matter. According to one of the researchers in their team, the first few ideas, he says the costume was so weird that Marvel comics. They look like superheroes basically. And then what they did do, now what they did was they went to study these lucky ideas, anything you can come up with. Now for the white team, the white cap, he called, I don't know how many people they call, aerodynamic experts, nanotechs, they went to spoken, nanotechs are producers, aircraft engineers, fluid dynamics, biomechanics. They, for the red cap, he went to spoke with a sports psychologist who told them that make the glass with the globules tinted blue and gray. Calm and soothing. The red cap. Now, at the end, they got a black cap person who everybody donned the black cap. Then they decided, they spoke about, is this feasible? Can we design the swimsuit? Can we design it in Mars? Can we produce it in Mars? And all that. Then finally, the blue cap kind of got it together. Now, what they ultimately came up with was they had goggles which were angular for more vision. And a cap in which the girl's hair was kind of tucked in with more space, and it was also put in such a way that it reduced the drag. So it's like, so they used the six thinking hats and they actually came up with a suit that made news. You Google it, you find this suit, Michael Phelps wearing it. It made news. It was there in the front page of every sports comic, the anime news, the Olympics, and it was good enough. So I concluded by saying that it's a revolutionary idea that did help a lot in decision making. Instead of making it destructive, it made it constructive. at the end of it, though the teams were chosen randomly, I think I ended up with an awesome team. So one cheer for our team, team number.
All right.